that's a requirement though. So to get into this posture, you're going to bring your legs up on top of those bolsters. And then line up your shoulder blades on the first block, the back of your head on the top block. And then your arms just come out to the side. And if you're really close to your neighbor, maybe just check out whose arm's going to go on top and whose arms are going to go on the bottom. And this will be our next posture.
The Boomy Davy.
back, and the days begin to get longer. That energy representing all the beginnings supports that forward movement of those next steps that you're wishing to take life. Often in the West, we celebrate New Year's in January. But if you feel called to the seasons, called to this time of the solstice, you can do that now or both.
Allow them to splash.
mind, like watching an image. These images pass like you watch an image on a movie screen. Moments here in this posture, really receiving here. consider coming out of this posture. So from here, start with gently walking those feet back towards the hips on top of the bolsters. And then from here, you can use your feet to press those bolsters away from you. Bring the feet onto the floor. And then two options to come out of this posture. One, you can just rotate the palms down towards the floor. Tuck your chin into your chest and peel yourself up off the bolster, or the blocks, excuse me. And then if you'd rather just roll to the right side, you can, right arm overhead, left arm over the belly. You roll to the right side, you know, position slowly. Yeah. So we'll just do a little bit for the spine, a little bit for the chest. Grab your blankets, you feel pretty good. Put underneath your knees. We'll go into a tabletop position. Yeah. And what we're going to do is spreading the toes, just going to some cat and cow pose. So connect the breath. As you inhale, stretch your hips towards the wall behind you. Maybe you can feel your sit bones spread, and then reach your heart forward, and your eye gaze just looks at the tip of the nose. And we exhale. Feel all the breath leave the body as your spine, your mid-spine, lifts towards the sky. And we inhale, scoop again, reaching the hips back, heart folded forward, shoulders down from the ears, eye gaze soft to the tip of the nose, and then we exhale out the mouth, clearing all the breath out of the lungs, really rounding the spine, drawing the belly in towards the spine, and then inhale, scoop out again, inviting those ribs to stretch apart from each other, exhale, we round. Allow those fingers to spread a little bit more. Go ahead and start moving on your own through your own cat and cow. Yeah, whether it's quicker than my voice, slower. Find that pace that feels good for you. Each vertebra stretching apart from each other. Once you get used to the movement, the direction that the spine is going, try and let go of the posture, right? Just let your body move with it. So you might add a little hip side to side or move with the head. How does your body want to move that S shape a little bit and feel good? do that threads around those shoulder blades. Lower back, the hips are pretty sturdy on this one. Try and keep the arms as straight as you can. Just move the chest forward and back. See if you can move a little bit quicker here. Let the chest drop and lift, drop and lift. Always have that side to side movement with the head. Yeah, it feels like it's ever getting into the head.
Start to consciously breathe into your hips.
spread the fingers and we spread the toes again, and we open up those energy lines of the body once more. Slide the elbows back towards the knees.
Breath, start exhale, sending that energy back down to the roots, tail, ground.
Call back to our energy.
reaching your hips towards your heels and slowly, gently lift yourself up. And we'll set the bolsters to the side and we're going to go into bridge, Sanchulanasana. So one block, just going to do the single block today. Come on to the back. Pigeon here on the block as well. So your block can either be on the first level, which is this, the second level. Any of you feeling the need to go up to the third level, give yourself at least 6 breaths on this level. And going up any higher than this is definitely not required. But we're going to reach your fingertips towards the heels. Step into the feet. Step into the feet so you start to feel that space already happening. That legs are activated, so the back just lifts up automatically off the floor. Then you lift the rest of the spine up one vertebrae at a time. Enough space to then slide that block underneath your pelvis and then set the hips back down. And the arms can just come out to the side, palms face up, and hip feels better for your shoulders. Wrap your hands around the block. This will be our next posture. How's the temperature? Are we good? Thank you.
Here's where we'll add that external hip chest stretch. We find pigeon variation. So stepping into that left foot. Exhale, draw your right knee in towards your chest. And then extend that right leg straight up towards the sky, reaching your right heel up. Spreading the toes, opening the foot. Then from here, exhale, cross that right ankle on top of the left thigh. Just let that right knee hang down towards the floor. Your right foot is reaching to that left wall. Yep, so you're holding up that wall to the left side of you with that right foot. Relax the shoulders. Sometimes when we get into the hips, the shoulders try to help. They do. Step more into that left foot. And any of you wanting a little more hip stretch on your next exhale, float your left foot up off the floor. Draw your knees towards you. Now, again, if this puts a lot of pressure on the neck and the shoulders, just bring the foot back down. If it feels good, stay here. Guiding that right thigh towards the front of your mat. And that might mean even bringing your right hand on top of that right thigh, pressing the right knee away from you. Breathe into that right hip.
Thank you.
feels good to stay here. Now, some of you get out there and you're like, how do you think I can get out of the car? A fuller stretch, a more satisfying restorative stretch. So walk a little higher, walk your feet back in, and then just rotate that block to whatever height feels good for you. And then maybe extend those legs towards the front of the mat.
High five them with your foot if that's available. This is fun.
then notice if you are kicking the legs, how the shoulders and arms are responding. Now, are you holding them in one place and just moving the legs? Allow those arms and legs to respond to each other. Responding off of that spine. We're going to just gently, slowly, the rocking back to stillness. And then slide the feet back together. Bend your knees and let the strap come off your feet. Roll to whichever side seems available to you for space. And then put the hands on the earth from that fetal position, whatever side you roll to. Gently lift yourself up to seated. Stepping one vertebrae at a time. Then once you're up to seated, onto our belly. And you may want your strap for this. So heads can face the center. Top of your mat. And then the strap is optional. So whatever feels restorative to you, do that one. Alright? So the strap's going to go around your ankle. Good.
Just a few more rounds of breath here in the sun. Reaching the pubic bone in the front of the hips down. Relaxing everything else around it. And when you're ready to release the left leg very slowly. Move the hips from side to side. Do a windshield wiper leg here. So laying on the belly. Bend your elbows like cactus arms. Set the strap to the side. Bend your knees, feet up. Look over to the left shoulder, release your feet over to the right just a little bit. Inhale, come back to center with the feet. Move your high gaze over to the right, release your feet to the left. Inhale, center, exhale, look left, feet go right. Inhale, center, exhale, look right, left. Just do one more each side. Legs come back to center. And then just look to see which side feels most available for you to roll into fetal position once more. Draw your knees into your chest. Feel the hands on the earth. Tuck your chin into your chest and gently lift yourself on up to seated. That is the left side, up to right, and we'll go into your Kriya Karani next, legs up the wall. So, you scoop your mats up towards the wall and you'll have one bolster and your blanket if you like that for traction, if you need a blanket to cover up with. Also, if you want this over here, if anyone needs an extra one. So, blanket goes over the bolster, and then so to get into this posture, step over here by the door, you're gonna bring your bolster up towards the wall, just a couple inches away. You're gonna sit inside of one hip, and sit down on top of the bolster. You're gonna lay down on that side, and then swing your legs up the wall. And if this is a newer posture getting into it, sometimes it takes a couple swings to bring the legs up. So don't get frustrated, and I'll be around to help you. I'm going to go here in the next posture. My bolster's in this. Hips, it feels better to get out to the side.
side, it feels better up overhead.